are you ready? With your Bible teacher, Carlos Carrillo, let's study the Bible.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Are You Ready? God loves you, and God has a plan for you, and happy Thanksgiving to all of you watching on YouTube around the world. I hope you had a great day today. Oro que hayan pasado un buen día. We did. We had a great time going to church, played basketball with my son. We served the Lord. We had a great weekend sharing the gospel. We met a person who rededicated her life to Christ in a parking lot. My wife was there speaking to him, and I was speaking. We were praying. We prayed with him to come to Christ. God is good. God is good. Don't miss the opportunities to share the gospel. All right, well, let's pray. Heavenly Father, we love you. We praise you. We thank you for this day. We ask Holy Spirit, direct everything that we say. Bring you glory. Bring you honor. We thank you, Holy Spirit. Gracias, Espíritu Santo, por lo que tú vas a hacer. En nombre de Cristo Jesús. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, welcome once again to Are You Ready? Please subscribe to this channel. Well, here we go. Tonight we're going to talk about what happened to Navy Secretary. The Navy Secretary was fired. We're just going to go right to that right now, and we're going to watch what happened in the news.
Tonight, a major shakeup at the Pentagon. The Navy Secretary is out, asked to resign by Defense Secretary Mark Esper over his handling of disgraced Navy SEAL Eddie Gallagher. Richard Spencer was already under pressure when he disputed reports about the controversy Saturday.
I did not threaten to resign, but let us just say that we're here to talk about external threats, and Eddie Gallagher is not one of them.
Tonight, the Pentagon chief called Spencer's actions deeply troubling. The Navy Secretary privately proposed to the White House that if officials did not interfere with a Navy review, Spencer would make certain Gallagher could retire with his SEAL membership and the coveted Trident pin. Secretary Esper said in a statement, "Unfortunately, as a result, I have determined that Secretary Spencer no longer has my confidence to continue in his position. I wish Richard well." The case of the Navy SEAL convicted of posing with a dead militant, but cleared of more serious war crimes, had already ignited controversy.
I just want to retire peacefully with all the honors that I've earned, get back to my family.
President Trump's Twitter bravado was not seen as an order, but caused tension when he wrote this Thursday. The Navy will not be taking away warfighter and Navy SEAL Eddie Gallagher's Trident pin. Gallagher's case attracted conservative support, and the president had previously used his power to restore Gallagher's rank and pay.
And Kelly, at this hour, we're hearing from Spencer. What is he saying about the president?
Kate, it's really a stunning letter of resignation where he says, "I no longer share the same understanding with the commander-in-chief who appointed me in regards to the key principles of good order and discipline. I cannot in good conscience obey an order I believe violates the sacred oath I took." That from Richard Spencer. We also know that the Secretary of Defense has decided that Eddie Gallagher will keep his Trident pin and retire as a Navy SEAL.
Does that make any sense to you? Anyway, the president gets involved. I've said it before, there is a spirit of confusion at the White House. Why did the Secretary of the Navy get fired? He got fired because he didn't agree with the president starting to pardon people who committed crimes. What are we doing? A lot of people in the military say, what is he doing? He's going against the flow because some people at Fox News decided to push for this man to be, he took pictures with a dead body. Hello? What are we doing? Is this something you're going to put up on your wall? Hello? Are you kidding me with this stuff? And this was okay? He committed all the crimes, and they shoved him under the rug. I mean, and so the Navy Secretary Spencer said, well, this doesn't make sense. It goes against my values and the core values of the military. These guys, this gentleman violated it. Why are we rewarding him? So that was it. So he went supposedly behind the back of the president, and the president should have said to Mr. Spencer, listen, Secretary, you need to go back to the Secretary of Defense. You talk to him. But the president didn't do that because he's used to doing things under the table, in secret. He's already done that with Ukraine. He's done that with Russia. He does that with everything. He likes to do things behind normal channel, the normal protocol. The President Trump goes against normal protocol. Lo hace constantemente. En vez de dejar decirle a este jefe de la nave, decir, mira, no puedes hablar conmigo, debes ir y hablar con el secretario de Estado. He should have told them. They were having some sort of conversation because he didn't tell them that. If he had told them, go talk to the Secretary of Defense, this man would never have been fired. I mean, it's just stupid. Anyway, Eddie Gallagher committed a crime. And so here we are, giving the guy the Trident Medal for the Navy SEAL, even after he got committed. So what are we saying? You can commit crime and still be rewarded. Go ahead. Retired colonel guilty of bribery here in Fort Gordon. Conspiracy. He was conspiring. He started his own company, Colonel's Cabal, by paying bribes to get bids on rigged for his company. At least about three other Army officers joined him here, Fort Gordon, Augusta, Georgia. Amazing. How much did he get? ¿Cuánto en este revolú y robando y recibiendo dinero del gobierno de la Fuerza Armada? Illegally, ilegalmente, dijo mentira, en fraude, 20 millones de dólares. And that happened here. All right, let's get to the Word of God. Tonight I want you to open up your Bibles to Hebrews chapter 4. Now, what I'm going to mention regarding there in what happened here with the Navy, Navy Commander, Navy Secretary, and in here in Augusta, Georgia, en estos dos casos, vemos el espíritu de confusión. 1 Corinthians 14:33. For God is not the God of, he's not a God of confusion. There is a spirit of confusion there in the White House, and it's roaming through the whole country. All right, so let's go to Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12. Hebreos 4, versículo 12. Let's go there quickly. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12. Hebrews 4, verse 12. Hebrews 4, verse 12. Hebrews 4, verse 12. And here we go. It says, for the word of God is living and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the division of soul and spirit, joints and marrow, and judges the thoughts and the intents of the heart. The first part we're going to look at is Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12. And the word of God is living and active. It's powerful. God's word is active. Living means life, gives life. God's word is active and energized. God's word probes into the deepest part of a person, just like a surgeon's knife. God's word probes. God's word penetrates. That's why the word of God brings conviction. It convicts people of sin. It convicts people of sin. So, That's because of the Holy Spirit. When you read the Bible, you should read it wanting to learn and to understand Scripture. Do you read the Bible just to read it and forget about it? No. Spend time in God's Word. Read it every day, and then because it is living and active, and the Bible says it is sharper than any double-edged sword. It means like a sword. It penetrates into the deep roots in sin. Cualquier pecado que puedas tener en tu corazón, la palabra de Dios penetre a esa área y empieza a limpiar, begins to clean you out. That's God's word. Let the word of God work, right? Don't keep it down here. Put it up here. And the word of God will offend people. La palabra de Dios va a ofender personas. We're not to make people feel good. We're supposed to speak God's word. And sometimes God's word, yes, is encouraging. God's word gives us hope. God's word gives us for the future. But God's word convicts us of sin. Okay? Amen. Do you know Jesus as your Lord and Savior? God sent his son to die for you on the cross for the forgiveness of your sins. And on the third day, he rose again. If you don't know him, I invite you to come to this heaven and the hell. Where would you be spending eternity? Are you ready for heaven or are you ready for hell? What are you ready for? ¿Dónde vas a pasar eternidad? Si no estás seguro, ora conmigo. Say, dear Lord Jesus, I repent of all my sins. I receive you as my Lord and Savior. Wash me in your precious blood. In Jesus' name, amen. Señor Jesús, me arrepiento de todos mis pecados. Te recibo como mi Rey y Salvador. Lávame en tu sangre preciosa, en nombre de Cristo Jesús. Amen. Heavenly Father, pray for every single person. Say yes to you. Fill them with your Holy Spirit. Give them a hunger for your word and connect them to a church where they can be discipled. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. If you gave your life to Christ, let us know at trustjesus19@gmail.com. Welcome to the family of God. Now, we won't be having any program through Monday through Friday. I'll be back next Saturday on Maranatha TV. Volveré, no va a haber programa, unless it's a major thing. I won't have it here in this setting. It may be in my car somewhere, whatever. Something quick, if something big happens, I'll do that. But if not, all the news will be done on Saturday. That's probably going to take about an hour, over an hour to do that one. So you're welcome to join us. And if you do see Maranatha TV, please subscribe. And subscribe to this one. Are you ready? All right? Live for Jesus, everybody. And remember, happy Thanksgiving. Feliz Día de Acción de Gracia para mi esposa, para mis hijos, para mi hijo Eli, mi hija Susana, mi hijo Carlos Israel, y para mis padres, para mis hermanos en Tampa. Feliz Día de Acción de Gracia, and all my wife's family also. Feliz Día de Acción de Gracia. Happy Thanksgiving. All right? Don't eat too much now. All right? But give thanks. Give thanks to the Lord. Dale gracias a Dios. And remember, Shalom, Shalom, Yerushalayim. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Shalom. Live for Jesus, everybody. Hallelujah. Live for Jesus.